When a non-current asset is purchased, we record them at their initial cost. So what are initial cost? Purchase price, non-refundable taxes, transport costs, net initial cost, site preparation costs. However, over time, these values may materially differ from their market value, it means their fair value.
After that, the company has the choice to choose whether to keep that asset in the historical value or revalue the asset and keep the revaluation value in the financial position. This is called current value measurement basis.
Students need to understand what is profit for the year and other comprehensive income and total other comprehensive income.
Let's look at the revaluation guidelines by LK60.
If a company chooses to revalue an asset, they must revalue all assets in that category. Revaluations must be regular. Subsequent depreciation must be based on the revalued amount. Gains from revaluation are not taken to the statement of comprehensive income because it is a recognized income, not a realized income. How to calculate the gain or loss on the revalued asset? Take the valuation or revalued amount from the question and take away the carrying value of the asset at the date of revaluation, and you will get the difference, that is revaluation gain or loss.
How to account for revalued asset?
The difference between revalued amount and original historical value. In case revalued amount is greater than historical cost, it will increase the original cost amount, so asset cost account will be debit.
Accumulated depreciation of original asset need to be removed since we have revalued new asset. So to reduce accumulated depreciation, we need to debit accumulated depreciation account. Both increased amount of asset cost account and removed accumulated depreciation account amounts will take up to revaluation reserve account under equity.
If we notice the all double entries, all are related with statement of financial position accounts, and remember, these entries are not going to affect the comprehensive income account. Let's look at revaluation at first time. There are two circumstances, one revaluation surplus and other one revaluation deficit. Revaluation surplus, we have already discussed this one. For the first time deficit, we will record the deficit as other expense, revaluation deficit, according to prudence concept. Then, until revalued date, we need to remove the accumulated depreciation of the old asset. Then finally, the both revaluation deficit and accumulated depreciation deduction, we will remove from the asset cost account. Let's look at the revaluation at second time. For example, a building was revalued in the previous year and had a revaluation surplus of rupees 1 million. This building is revalued again in the year end of the accounting period. So the first scenario, if revaluation has given a deficit of rupees 800,000. So it is in year end, no entries for accumulated depreciations. So first we need to deduct rupees 800,000 from revaluation reserves account, because already we have a revaluation surplus balance of rupees 1 million from the previous year. So the balance of rupees 200,000 will be for revaluation reserve as at the year end under equity. And for this year, we had a revaluation deficit of rupees 800,000. It will be shown in the other comprehensive income. Then the second scenario, if revaluation deficit is 1.3 million. So first we can deduct the revaluation deficit to the extent of our revaluation surplus account balance. So we already have a revaluation surplus of rupees 1 million in the revaluation reserve equity account. So debit the revaluation reserve account by rupees 1 million. So now we don't have any balance from revaluation reserve account. And for this year, we had a revaluation deficit of rupees 1 million in the other comprehensive income. And for the remaining 300,000 will be recorded as other expenses in the profit and loss account. Both the revaluation deficit and other expenses will be credited to building cost account. revaluation at second time when we heard a revaluation deficit in the previous year. The machine is revalued in our year end of accounting period. So the first scenario is if we have a revaluation surplus of 400,000. The machine value increased by 400,000. So we need to increase the machine account by debiting. And in the previous year, we had charged 500,000 in the P&L as other expense. So for this year, we can reduce our expense to the extent of 500,000. Since this year surplus is 400,000, we can reduce the expense by 400,000. Here, the very good understanding is reducing the expense means recording as income, so credit in the profit or loss account. Then the second scenario is if we have a revaluation surplus of 700,000. The machine value is increasing by 700,000, so the machine cost account is debit by 700,000. In the previous year, we have recorded 500,000 as other expenses in the profit and loss, so we can record income to the extent of 500,000. So in the P&L, we record other income of 500,000 and the balance of rupees 200,000 is the revaluation reserve for this year, and it will go to both revaluation reserve under equity in balance sheet and as a revaluation reserve in the other comprehensive income.